If you were to be whirled back in time, visiting the various periods of Earth's long history, which prehistoric aquatic creatures would be most likely to take you out? And I don't mean on a date. Today we're talking about which of these underwater animals would be most likely to either stuff you in their bellies or send you shuffling off this mortal coil in another manner. And while I adore the beasties of the Mesozoic, I'll be making a special point to highlight lesser-known animals from the Paleozoic and Cenozoic eras, going from low to high danger levels. We'll approach this scenario almost like Subnautica. You're in full scuba gear, can eat and drink through your suit, and have enough oxygen to last for several hours. The mysterious alien forces that brought you here will plop you down in different watery environments across time, bring you back to life each time you die, and record their findings. Some of those environments will be fresh or brackish water. Sea creatures just works better as a video title. And remember, we're starting with the animals that will cause the fewest fatalities and ramping up to the major threats at the end. Blah 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 blah. Let's start with those primeval water beasties likely to kill you the fewest amount of times. That can be due to small size, a different preferred diet, or a habitat where you're unlikely to encounter them. They may be able to take you out if they wanted, but that doesn't mean they'll go out of their way to do so. Paleozoic was a gigantic ammonite that lived in shallow waters in the late Cretaceous. At well over a ton, it may have been the heaviest cephalopod in Earth's history. Its grasping arms and sharp crushing beak could deliver a death straight out of a nightmare. But we don't consider it likely to attack humans. It would have preferred capturing smaller prey in the ocean currents as it floated in the water. Still, if you find yourself accidentally grabbed by a Paleozoic, there won't be much you can do. We'll remember you fondly. Endocirus would have been much slower than non-shelled cephalopods, but if it caught you, it was definitely big enough to overpower you. It's hard to get more intimidating than what resembles a giant squid covered in plate armor, although Endocirus's diet likely wouldn't have included human-sized animals. Again, if it does capture you, it's game over. But we don't believe it would be actively hunting you. Small nothosaurs could absolutely do significant damage to a human diver, given how many are human-sized themselves, but again, it's a matter of prey preference. You'd be big and strange enough that they probably wouldn't bother you too much. Unless, of course, nothosaurs secretly were hunters of big game, and their small heads and teeth were merely clever disguises to fool paleontologists from the future. Radiodonts like Anomalocaris specialized in taking down soft-bodied prey in open water, using their grasping appendages to stab and crush small victims. Anomalocaris could do a good deal of damage to your soft tissue if it felt threatened or swiped you by accident, but you're far too large for it to attack on purpose. Still, we're discussing fatalities, not necessarily predation events, and the injuries an Anomalocaris could cause to a human diver are not insignificant. Watch out. Teleosaurus was a fully marine crocodile relative from the Jurassic. It had a very gharial-like build. Modern gharials tend to avoid humans and focus on fish, giving us a good idea of how Teleosaurus would likely behave when confronted by a human swimming around its territory. Could it mess you up? Absolutely. Would it want to? Not unless you gave it a reason. Elasmosaurian elasmosaurs were a group of plesiosaurs that became highly specialized in attacking schools of fish with their long necks. The theory is that they would have approached from a distance, and their skulls were so far away from their stout bodies that the fish wouldn't recognize it as a threat until it was too late. Given their proportions and focus on fish eating, we doubt elasmosaurians would go out of their way to attack prey too large to fit in their jaws. Unless they're curious or rebellious, in which case nature will take its course and you will no longer exist. It happens. Adult Leviathan melvoli were absolutely gigantic predators, between 26 and 57 tons and at least over 13 meters long, with maximum estimates of nearly 18 meters. Their skulls were the size of a car, and their teeth were a foot long. Leviathan specialized in hunting other whales, and if it saw a small morsel like you swimming in the Miocene Ocean, may not have bothered to even snap you up. If it were starving, of course, that's a different matter. Large predators don't always have to hunt large prey after all, and they'll take easy calories when they can get them. Given its specialization, however, we're comfortable putting Leviathan in the low casualty category. Leedsichthys problematicus was the largest bony fish of the Jurassic period and may have been the largest bony fish ever, at about the size of a school bus. It wasn't a macro predator, instead functioning as a humpback whale-sized suspension feeder. Its huge mouth gulped down water and then filtered zooplankton through its gill rakers. As a result, it wouldn't have viewed you as anything more than a passing curiosity, but we do recommend staying away from its mouth. Such an enormous gape could easily engulf you, and that's not a great way to go. Archelonius kairos is the largest turtle known from the fossil record. It's the size of a van and has a thick, powerful beak for capturing jellyfish, mollusks, and armored crustaceans that would have been moving around the ocean floor. Its thick armor protected it from the orca-sized mosasaurs it lived with. It was certainly capable of shearing off your limbs with its beak and may try it on occasion for the sake of novelty. However, it was likely a slow swimmer, and if you see one coming, you can convince it that you're not worth the effort by simply swimming away. Medium casualties represent animals that would cause notable fatalities, either thanks to their diet, location, or behavior. Large eurypterids would terrorize the shallows of Ordovician oceans. Anytime you'd dive out from a beach, you'd need to watch out for gigantic, scorpion lobster-like arthropods with stabbing legs and powerful pinchers that could snap your arm in half. There's a possibility that they could have lurked as ambush predators in the sand, making exploring the region incredibly dangerous. The biggest of them were also several times the mass of a typical adult human. Cymbospondylus was an early ichthyosaur, representing a primitive eel-like form from the early Triassic. It was also a gigantic apex predator, with a robust skull comparable in size and morphology to many large theropods. Cymbospondylus youngorum reached 17 meters in total length and would be able to fit an entire human in its jaws. It wasn't terribly fast compared to later ichthyosaur morphs, however, so it lands in the medium casualties territory. Aristonectine elasmosaurids are more likely to target humans than their elasmosaurine cousins, with their thicker necks and larger skulls. Aristonectes itself was huge at over 10 meters long, and could easily bite a diver in half. Its hydrodynamic shape and long paired fins would give it incredible swimming speed that you couldn't hope to match. I only rank them in medium because they were likely used to hunting large, fast fish, and might not find a random slow-moving mammal very interesting. If they did, though, they'd be very high on the list. Enchetuthis was an enormous cephalopod from Cretaceous North America. Closely related to modern octopuses, while superficially resembling a huge squid, their beak and arms would be able to cause mortal wounds on a human. If they were as aggressive in modern Humboldt squids, they would rank much higher. Even large octopus and squids today have attacked ships, boats, and divers when provoked by lights or movement. An Enchetuthis attack would be like a scene out of a thalassophobe's worst nightmare. This is totally cheating, but I feel bad for leaving Titanoboa out of the land predator and aquatic predator videos. I never know where to put the dang thing. This huge snake may have hunted in river systems in prehistoric Colombia, and running into one would be a death sentence. At 12 meters long and over a metric ton, Titanoboa is basically the basilisk from Harry Potter. It lived with huge turtles and crocodilians and could easily swallow a human whole. Maybe even by accident. The high casualties category brings up the prehistoric equivalent of hippos and crocodiles, animals that you'd encounter fairly frequently in your time travels, and that would also happily and easily end your mortal existence. Dacosaurus was a metriorhynchid crocodilomorph comparable in size to modern Nile crocodiles. It was fully marine, living its entire life in the ocean, and would have given life birth. It was also a physical menace. Its jaws were filled with slightly curved conical teeth that made it a powerful predator. Its fins and paddle tail would allow it to easily outspeed you, and you're in the ideal prey size bracket. Hopefully by now you're starting to realize why traveling to a prehistoric ocean is a bad idea. Dunkleosteus and Gorgonichthys were huge carnivorous placoderms, a group of armored fish that ruled the Devonian seas. Placoderms were generally stout and robust with powerful jaws, sharpened for use as bony shears. Take a great white, squish the image a little, and cover it in plate armor, and you have a good idea of what you might be dealing with. They're much faster than you, you can't effectively fight them, and they can open and close their jaws faster than the human eye can blink. Your arm would be missing before you could process what was happening, and the rest of your body would quickly follow. Deinosuchus, Sarcosuchus, and Purosaurus aren't exactly sea creatures, but remember that I did say we'd include some fresh and brackish water species. Each of these enormous semi-aquatic reptiles could fit a human in their jaws and had the explosive power to ambush you before you could dodge. Deinosuchus and Sarcosuchus lived in the Mesozoic alongside huge dinosaurs, and Purosaurus terrorized Miocene South America. The mercy is that these crocodilians and philidosaur would bite you out of existence pretty much instantly. Crocodilus anthropophagus is aptly named, the human-eating crocodile. It lived in Pleistocene Tanzania and was even bigger than the modern saltwater crocodile, reaching lengths of 7.5 meters and masses of a ton and a half. Hominid remains from the area preserve bite marks matching this fella's jaws, so we not only predict that it would go after you, we know that it did go after animals that looked awfully similar to you. Stay out of rivers, kids. Or oceans. Or lakes. Just, maybe this whole time traveling thing was a bad idea. Basilosaurus cetoides was a gigantic Eocene whale that resembled a huge snake. Its slim serpentine build let it cut through the ocean quickly, and its skull was jammed full of crushing and piercing teeth. We have the stomach contents of some specimens, so we know that it ate prey as big as large sharks. You would absolutely be on the menu. Acrophysiter was a relatively small macroraptorial sperm whale from Miocene Peru, and had jaws spawned from the pits of outer darkness. At 4 to 5 meters or 13 to 15 feet long, it would find a human-sized prey item highly interesting. It likely preyed on seals in its own time, and you would be much easier to catch. It's fast, it's hungry, it's intelligent, and it could rip you apart with a single bite. Mastodonsaurus would be a terror in swampy Triassic environments. Perhaps the largest amphibian known from the fossil record, Mastodonsaurus was up to 6 meters long and would have weighed over a metric ton. Its skull was broad and powerful, with jaws lined by hundreds of sharp hooked teeth. In a world famous for land crocs and early dinosaurs, Mastodonsaurus was a forgotten apex predator. Himalayasaurus and other mega ichthyosaurs like Temnodontosaurus aren't just incredibly dangerous towards stray humans. They're some of the deadliest, most powerful aquatic predators in the history of the planet. They were sleek, fast killers with active metabolisms and powerful bites. Himalayasaurus matched the size of many adult humpback whales and had a robust skull to match its size. Temnodontosaurus wasn't quite as big, but was still larger than the biggest orcas and could take down nearly anything in its environment. It also had soft tissue structures on its fins that permitted it to swim silently in pursuit of prey. Not only could these things eat you in one bite, but you might never even know what it was that killed you. Young Ototus sharks, including Ototus megalodon and Ototus auriculatus, were likely to enjoy snack-sized humans. The adults are thought to have eaten proportionally larger prey, but the juveniles wouldn't turn down a free-floating lunchable from the future. They were far too fast to outswim, and even the younger Ototus individuals and smaller species would be able to swallow you whole or get close to it. It's the equivalent of biting a banana into bits. Large mosasaurs like Mosasaurus, Tylosaurus, and Pronathodon would treat human divers like popcorn. Their skulls were nearly 2 meters long in the biggest species, and their railroad-spiked teeth could pierce through a diving suit without any issue at all. Chemical studies show that mosasaurs were likely endothermic, and would have been able to swim at notable speeds for long periods of time. No use in running. Swimming. Plus, there's the fact that these marine lizards were everywhere during the Cretaceous, and it's little wonder that they're classified as a high-casualty organism. Spinosaurus is not a sea creature. Probably. We do have a pretty decent idea of its ecology, despite the memes, and it would have preyed on large fish and shoreline animals in Cretaceous North Africa. If you were near, on, or in the river, you'd be under threat from a 3-to-8-ton theropod with claws like kopeshes and jaws big enough to snap you in half. Just don't bring your satellite phone. Cephactinus swallows you whole. Unironically, out of everything on this list, I would be most worried about this late Cretaceous murder fish. Cephactinus, or sword ray, was a 6-meter-long ichthyodactiform supercarnivore that ate human-sized prey in a single horrifying swallow. They were equal opportunity eaters, devouring fish nearly their own size, even if it killed them. Their forward-facing teeth would spear their victims and allow them to gulp down prey without breaking them into pieces, relying on digestion to dissolve them. It's the perfect storm. They're huge, they're ridiculously fast, and they would absolutely see humans as nothing more than a light snack. Their aggression and willingness to eat whatever swam is what makes them ultimately the most dangerous sea creature to swim in prehistoric oceans. Thanks for watching! Make sure to subscribe if you like prehistoric animals and hypothetical scenarios, and comment with videos you'd like to see. Feel free to join the channel to support my work. You receive shoutouts and loyalty badges at the raptor level, along with early access to videos at the megatheropod level. I'm the Vividen, and I'll see you next time.